Hello students, I am Dr. Uma Devi Jadrankunti, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Government First Grade College, Rajnagar, Hubballi. It comes under the Karnataka University, Dharwad. In a fifth sem, paper 2, Ethology and Economic Zoology, in that we are going to study the social organization of Lungus for the Session 9, Unit 3. Social organization is nothing but the animals. We are going to study the group and make the labor of work. So about this session, objective and outcome is to understand the social organization, and those are in the groups, that is known as the troops of Lungus. Outcome of this session is outline the primate socialization or organization pattern, interaction, caste system, and survivability of the Lungus and endangered species we are going to study. So the Lungus are performed in different troops. As I told earlier, the group of Lungus is nothing but the troops. All male groups tends to be the smallest of the groups and can consist of adults, sub-adults and juveniles. Some populations have only multiple male groups as mixed sex groups, while others have only one male groups as mixed sex groups. So here all male groups is a small troop, along with that adults, sub-adults and juveniles are there. And in some populations, in another group or another troop, multiple alleles are there. Those are the mixed sex. And in some are only the males. Only the males. Here, three types of the troops takes place. The northern plain grey Lungus can live in several different types of the groups. It can live in groups of multiple males and females, one male or multiple females, or multiple males with no females, and males can also live alone without a group. Single male groups are most common in the northern plain grey Lungus. Group size can be exceed about 100 monkeys are there. So in the proboscis monkeys generally live in a groups composed of one adult male, some adult females and their offsprings. All male groups may also exist. Some individuals are solitary, means single, and mostly the males are single. Monkey groups live in a overlapping home ranges with little territoriality in a fashion fusion society, with the groups gathering at a sleeping site at the night falls. Means those Lungus or monkeys are behaves the social organization. The social organization is a nothing but a group. In group, each individual perform the functions, that is the welfare of the group or welfare of the species. The social organization is very important in the social organized animals like termites, like honeybee, Lungus, human beings, where they perform the different functions, that is welfare of the society. The social organization of human Hanuman Lungus in a mosaic of moist deciduous forest and anthropogenic meadow, the Lungus of 14 troops, 13 were one male and one was trimale. Means in a one male group is there, 13 were one male group, or one group having the three males. The population's adult sex ratio was 1:2.5. The majority of female sexual solicitation was directed towards the male. The number of males per group is the most variable aspect of primate social organization and is often related to the monopolizability of females, which is mainly determined and their reproductive synchrony. Colobins, that is, shows both male and female interaction. The colobins, nothing but grooves, shows the both interspecific and intraspecific variations. Bi-tailed langurs are formed. So synchrony, that is, the same groups perform the social organization. So here we can consider the Nilgiri langurs and the Hanuman langurs and the black-faced langurs and the white-faced langurs. The social organization is very common in the primates. So next, the primates to the human beings. So that is why well-organized social organization in the human beings also. So these are the proboscis, long proboscis that is found in the northern areas. The proboscis langurs are there. Langurs are leafy eating, tree residing, forest dwelling monkeys are there. They are regarded as the among the most arboreal of all old world monkeys. The arboreal means the animals which are living on the tree. Almost all the langurs, they can spend their time on the trees. Leaf eating, tree residing and forest dwelling is a common in the old world monkeys. They are active throughout the tree canopy, the group of the trees that is known as the canopy, thick forest, and can be found in both primary and secondary forests. They rarely come to the ground. When they do, it is mainly to gain access to mineral source. So most langurs are grayish, brownish or blackish with paler underparts. Some have light colored markings on their head or stripes on their thighs. Langurs adults weigh from 5 to 8 kilograms and have a head and a body length of 42 to 61 centimeter and a tail length of 50 to 85 centimeter. Langurs are a type of leaf-eating monkeys. Those multi-chambered stomach allows them to digest the starchy plant food in between feeding times. They have to store the food inside the stomach. The complicated digestive system is a reason for their big belly. So that is why the langurs having the enlarged stomach. So the langurs have a high fiber diet, which can range from leaves and unripe fruits to bark and blossom are slowly digested by the langurs. Unique gut flora digested during their long rest period. Langurs belonging to a family of primates known as Cercopithecinae are old world monkeys. An extremely large family of primates, about 159 species are found. Generally 23 genera are presently recognized, range across the Africa, India, East and Southeast Asia. Langurs tend to be a small with a around 7 to 15 members, including a dominant male and 3 or more females and their young. In some cases, you can find monogamous pairs. A typical group embraces a territory 35 to 40 hectares. So males not in a group may form all male groups. Many langur and Asian colobin monkeys form territorial groups of related females, natal groups, that is a small one, young ones, who appeared to safeguard availability to resources and allow preferential access to a single male, but usually for no more than 2 years. So social organization is well in the langurs. They have to in the troops or colobins. They have to show the aggressive nature and although they perform the labor of work that adult take the care of the troop and the young ones are get the care by the adults one, and females and males are in the ratio according to their territory, and Nilgiri Langoose proboscis long proboscis langoose, and commonly around us the monkeys species are in the troops system. Social organization is well in the apes next to the man. Social organization is important to the survivability of the organisms and continuity of the life. Social organization of the langoose have the 5 MCQ questions. First one is the most endangered primate species in India: golden langur, grey langur, Hanuman langur, and proboscis monkey. So first one is the golden langur. All adult male groups is the characteristics of social structure, that is a grey langurs. Which langurs are known as the sacred langurs? That is the northern plain grey langurs. Old world monkey are found in North India, South India, East India, none of the above. You can find out the South India. Langurs are leaf eater, fruit eater, seed eater, and none of the above. You can find out the leafy eaters are the characteristics of the langurs. So many are sacred langurs. You know that one Hanuman langur is a in our Ramayana. We can see the sacred animal. So that is why in many langurs are known as the sacred langurs. In Indian system, the langurs and monkeys are an important role in the social organization. Thank you.